Hey y'all, this is Jack Harlow, and this is What Would Jack Do? My dating life is doomed. I'm what you would consider a nice guy. I lack confidence with women, and I'm on the sensitive side. I've tried all sorts of things over the years to meet women. I feel like I've tried everything, but I'm still self-conscious about getting the women I want. What would you do? I mean, some people are just meant to be beta. And so maybe you should just beta it out. I feel like you're getting the batch of women that are meant for you. And I'm not sure how much mobility you'll find if you continue to be yourself, which I think you should be yourself. You just gotta find it deep within yourself to feel yourself. You gotta feel yourself. I recently discovered the unfinished rosary-like tattoo on my boyfriend's back gets one new pearl for every girl he sleeps with or dates. He gave me 4 pearls on his back as a surprise present for our second year together. When he did the surprise, I thought he was joking and just wanted pearls. I got ridiculously upset. He took it very badly and won't talk to me until I apologize. Am I wrong to think this is a red flag? What would you do? I don't know if this is a red flag. I have the same tattoo. So it's really not that bad. I just added a pearl last night, so. Recently, I saw a text on my boyfriend's phone from a female coworker that read, "Sandwiches on your desk, bud," winky face. Yes, coworkers do that kind of stuff, but I couldn't help that my blood boiled. I trust my man, but I also feel uncomfortable with him being this close with female coworkers. Am I being ridiculous here? How do I keep my cool and not let this bother me? I mean, why are you going through his phone, though? That's all I'm saying. It's an invasion of privacy. But they're definitely fucking. Sandwiches on your desk, bud. Nah, because some people wink like that. Some people, and it's not an emoji. It's the semicolon with the parentheses, the old school wink that got the sociopath energy to it. Like, a lot of people use that wink. I don't know what it's about. You never know what they mean, so I wouldn't jump to conclusions. She may have just been giving him a sandwich. Probably fucking no. My friend's car broke down and she demanded that I wire her a ridiculous amount of money for a tow or drive 130 miles to pick her up. When I politely refused, she threw a fit. She routinely lies and invents medical ailments to get out of doing things. What's the breakup protocol with a friend? What would you do? Well, at least this person knows it's time to break up with this friend. I was worried we were gonna get to the end of this. Like, how do I handle this friendship? All right, clean break. I'll just clean break. Don't be rude about it. Just say, I don't want you in my life anymore. I always worry about breaking off with people because they might be vindictive or vengeful. They might try to hurt your life after. You gotta figure out the best way to do it. Just wish them the best. That's the best thing to do.